have this very interesting container and tiny home combo for you all today. The owner started with a 20-foot container. They then added on about an additional 200 square feet of space or so. There's also some great amenities on this property, everything from a hot tub to a fire pit to this cool game room that you share with the other guests. There's also some yurts and a dome on this property. We were out here in rural Ohio today, about 2 hours outside of Cincinnati. So a lot for us to check out at this very unique build. Let's go and hop into it and start the tour. Welcome to this very interesting container and tiny home combo out here in Ohio. This is actually the backside of the home. If we get a little closer, you can see the clear separation with the 20-foot container on the left and the tiny home addition over there on the right. We also have lots of outdoor deck space, which I'll get to shortly, but now we're gonna go to the front side of this home, which looks like this. From this angle, you can see more of the main deck, and it has a large overhanging roof portion to it. But next, we're actually gonna walk over here to another outdoor deck, and right beneath the home, this is your comfortable fire pit area. Firewood is provided at this Airbnb, so I grabbed some and some matches, and I'm gonna light this thing up, and we are now all good to go. You're also right on the edge of the woods, so it's very peaceful. And finally, if we take the drone and kind of go up further to get a bird's eye view, this will give you a better idea of the entire layout of this home. Now I'm going to walk up this staircase to the main deck to check it out. And here we are. This is what you'll see as we pan from left to right. We get a little bit closer now. Just against the container, you have a little sitting area with three tables surrounding you. Opposite of that, you then have a nice grill so you can do some barbecue in the warmer months. Further into the deck, you then have your hot tub. Can never go wrong with one of these, and it's also really cool because the sun sets right over the hot tub. We're now going to walk up this other staircase to the final exterior space, and this will take us to the upstairs deck. I would say you technically have three outdoor decks, I guess, between this one, the main deck that we just saw, and the fire pit area. So you have no shortage of options to enjoy the great outdoors. Up here though, you have another couch and a little table. And if you walk to the far end, you have two more chairs and a dining table so you can have your meals outside. Last but not least, I also want to briefly mention that there are some domes and yurts on this same property. So if the container home is booked, you can look into staying at one of their other units. Finally, this is what some of the beautiful surrounding area looks like. We are in Logan, Ohio, but that's it for everything on the exterior. Let's now go inside. As soon as you enter, you will be in the kitchen area straight ahead. It's quite an open floor plan, and we are technically inside of the container right now, which is a little under 150 square feet. If you now walk to the far end and open up this door, we'll come into your bathroom. It's a little on the smaller side, but you have your sink on the left, a bunch of towels on the right, and your toilet opposite of that. You may also notice right there in the middle is your shower. And if you walk in and kind of curve it around like this, you have your shower curtain. If this is too cramped for you, there is another bathroom on the property. More on that later. We'll now exit the bathroom back into the kitchen. You have a ton of countertop space, then one of those cool kind of retro looking refrigerators and a microwave on top at the far end. You also have a bunch of utensils and essential cooking supplies, everything from cooking oil to salt and pepper, and a few items to help you wash the dishes. In this cabinet, you have a ton of pots and pans, as you do have a stovetop on the far right-hand side. You also have your knives and your coffee maker on top of this shelf. After finishing up in the kitchen, we're now gonna walk further into this main living space. Right next to the fridge, you have a nice comfy blue sofa, a footstool, and up top you have a shelf which has some nice decorations. And actually there on the left, you have an Amazon Alexa. The table to the left of the sofa, I learned, is actually a fold-out table later, so I ate my dinner on top of it. You also have a goodie basket with some snacks, instructions on Alexa, and some info on their garden. Along the opposite wall, you have some more decorations, a little mirror, and actually over here, you do have a smart TV there on the left, which has Netflix and all that good stuff. Finally, to finish off in this room, I discovered later that this couch is actually also a sofa bed. It's super easy to operate. You just grab some of the handles and pull out this extra cushion and you're good to go. Now we'll head to the new bedroom. And here is the master bedroom. It is 160 square feet. Over here, you can pull this across for some added privacy. You also have a luggage rack and this very comfy chair and a footrest. This thing also swings around, so of course I had to have my fun, but this is a nice chill out space. We'll now focus more on the bedroom as you begin to pan to the left. You have some beautiful natural light streaming in from those two large windows. You then have a comfy mattress and a ton of pillows. And along this wall, you actually have a fireplace, which is a very nice amenity, and another smart TV up there. So you actually have two smart TVs inside of this home. Now, right next to the container home, this is your game room. It is one of the coolest parts about staying here, so let's go check it out. Welcome to the amazing game room. There is so much to do inside this place, you will never get bored during your stay. In this first corner, you have a darts game. I've actually never played darts before, but it was so much fun, and I even hit a few bullseyes. Not bad for my first time. Right next to that, you have what I would call an extended guest book. There are a bunch of whiteboards around the game room. You can read what other guests have written, where they're from, why they're staying. It's a really cool idea. In this corner, you have a fridge and a huge couch. But of course, the main centerpiece in this room is the billiards table. I played a decent amount growing up at my grandparents' house. This just never gets old. Moving along to this far wall, you have even more games waiting for you. One of the all-time greats, you have cornhole, which you can play, and also can jam. Beginning to finish up, you also have shuffleboard against this wall, and in one of the last corners, you have a little sitting area if the couch is taken up by other guests. Finally, you do actually have a bathroom inside of the game room. It's a full bath with a shower, toilet, sink, everything you need. So if that smaller bathroom in the container home isn't doing it for you, you can walk on over to this restroom in the game room. Thank you for watching, guys, and I'll see you very soon for another Airbnb tour.